shall attempt to answer the lifelong question. How long is a piece of string? Now, as I'm sure you can see, I have a collection of string sizes, because not every string is identical. This one is actually exceeds the length of that ruler, but that is fine. See, I have, there is tools to use for this measuring process. Now, these tweezers don't, they're not ideal for picking up. Oh, I don't know, actually, that did that quite easily. I was struggling a moment ago. Perhaps I need some different tweezers. Of this, these would be perfect. And I don't believe there is any frayed edges, perhaps a few, but that is not our concern today. No. Measurements amongst different measuring tools, as they do greatly vary. See that? What's that? Perhaps 1.9. Longer lengths. I need something more precise for this. Perhaps. Yes, I think 1.9 is a fair assumption to make for that. Looks around 3.3 perhaps there, but let's just check across quite so easy as the string does not wish to be straight. I suppose that's coming in for 3, yes, 3.45, 3.45, now we can move you aside now, this is very similar to the previous one. Does this read it? Oh, let's just straighten. Place that on the zero. Yes, that is 4 on the dot. Yes, it was a easy one. Now, we do have some longer ones. Perhaps that's 2, I'm not sure. Let's see what we have here. I almost need another set of tweezers too. We need to go then it's much better, so we go from the move that aside. Now we go from about 12.6. That'll be it. 'Twill allow more than enough. There. Let me buy that to the very end. There's a 0. This one. See, so line to the 0 there, and then 10.3 perhaps. Yeah, so I'd say about 10.3. Let's try and get that right on the end there. 10.12. I would say the more precise measuring, I'd say that was a 12.2. Now, let's us to another red one. Pop this round the other way. Just like that. That looks very close to 12, or maybe 12.05. Yes. It's quite interesting. Those past three have been very similar sized, but not precisely the same, which is the purpose of this exercise. Let me get right there. Oh no. And then find a zero. So down 1, 2, 3, 4 red, 1, 2, 3 black. So let's do another black. I know there's more red than black, but zero, and then that's 13.4. That's not long enough there. Let me just zero, 13. Yes, 13.4. Line 4, 0. No, that's not close enough to the end. That's better. Looks quite a lot like 11.4. Just to make certain. Yes, I'm going to go with 11.3 for that. is that? 1, 2, these zeros, so then we go 20.4. Doesn't actually reach long enough, so I'll just have to come over to this, approximately there. Oh no, that looks more like 20.5, so we do have a bit of a discrepancy here, but so it's either 20.4 or 20.5. I think it's 20.45. This, oh no, this is in fact two pieces, not one. Secure that to the end, secure that to the other end, and we have a 21.1 perhaps. Let me see across here. Perhaps, and then 21.2 red is, what was that, 21.2, so that is the measurement I shall the final one. Let's see, I do believe this to be the, yes, substantially longer than the previous string. This to the end. Now I do believe this is longer than this. Yes. Much longer than that. So I need to clear some space here. Just with this rearrangement. You see, I should now be able to like 37 across there. Let me double click here. Just there. Yes, 37.1. side. Now I do just have one more to fulfill my curiosity. Attached to this, there is this piece of string. Let's see, shall we? To be about 16.2. Let me check across here. Yes, that looks like 16.2 for the T-back string. Session, I do feel. Well, I do hope this has been a useful resource to you, and I do feel I've only begun to scratch the surface. I feel I will need to return to this. Such questions as how long is a piece of string cannot be answered so simply. No. So I will return to this, but for now I feel we have made you take care of yourself. I hope to see you sometime soon. See you later.